I was working for Nestle in Africa for 7 years, managing the dairy business for a few West African countries. Then I left and went traveling. And as I traveled, I saw all these investment opportunities in various emerging and frontier markets. So I decided to start blogging about this. The blog is called thewanderinginvestor.com. Essentially, the idea is I travel, I look at various investment opportunities, I speak to lawyers, I speak to fund managers, I speak to real estate agents, and then if people want to get in touch with them directly, then they can. My main job really is managing my own money. So this blog is something that I'm doing on the side, but I'm really trying to help people because people are looking for options and it's hard to find that sort of information. Africa's fascinating from a demographic point of view. The population is booming and there are a lot of companies on the smaller stock exchanges, such as in Rwanda, Kenya, Ghana, Ivory Coast, where companies have dividend yields in the double digits, where they're growing 15% a year and have zero debt on their balance sheets. So for this, I invested in a fund called the African Lions Fund, managed by an Australian based out of Tanzania. Real estate in Kyiv, Ukraine is extremely interesting these days because it has some of the highest rental yields in the world. The easiest way for people to have a very good return on investment is generally to move to a lower cost country with lower taxes. So not only do they save money in their everyday lives, but they also save a lot of money in terms of taxes. Montenegro is a very good example. Some of my own family moved there. Very low cost of living and amazing lifestyle. My goal is to help people maximize their freedom in a world where freedom is under attack.